Let's move on and talk about the different types of inflation that exist and potential consequences. Demand pull inflation is inflation that starts as a result of an increase in aggregate demand. It can be caused by any factor that shifts aggregate demand. Initial increase in aggregate demand will result in a new shortened macroeconomic equilibrium at a higher price level and a higher level of real GDP. Unemployment falls below the natural rate and an inflationary gap is created. It is hard to sustain a higher than potential GDP equilibrium, and a shortage of labor occurs, causing the wage rate to rise. This makes the short-run aggregate supply curve shift back to restore long-run equilibrium. For it to be considered inflation, aggregate demand must increase consistently, and the only way for that to happen is if the quantity of money in the economy consistently increases. Cost push inflation starts when production costs for an economy as a whole increase. An increase in the money wage rate or raw materials could cause such an outcome. The short-run supply curve shifts to the left, resulting in a higher price level and a higher unemployment rate, higher than the natural unemployment rate. In this situation, the central bank increases the money supply to boost aggregate demand in order to restore long-run equilibrium. A situation in which real GDP decreases and the price level rises, caused by a decrease in the short-run aggregate supply, is called stagflation. As with any inflation process, there must be a sustained increase in the general price level. Thus, the process must be reoccurring for it to be considered inflation. If inflation is expected, then there are no fluctuations in real GDP. Increases in the price level will occur, but the economy will remain at the long-run quantity of real GDP. If aggregate demand, for example, is expected to increase, then the money wage rate will increase in anticipation. Thus, both aggregate demand and short-run aggregate supply will shift simultaneously, maintaining long-run equilibrium. A rational expectation is the best forecast that can be made with the information available at a particular time. When the inflation forecast is correct, the economy will continue operating at full employment. If aggregate demand grows faster than expected, the inflation rate exceeds the expected rate, and the economy experiences demand pull inflation. If aggregate demand grows slower than expected, the rate of inflation slows.